Welcome to EPG Patsala. I am Dr. Abu Saleh. I teach at Raja Paramohan College, University of Calcutta. This paper is titled as English Literature between 1590 to 1798. And this particular module is on the tragedies in between 1590 to 1798. This module is prepared by Dr. Manirul Islam. He is an assistant professor of English at Acharya Jagadish Chandra Bose College, University of Calcutta. In this module, we will be discussing various tragedies, their rise of tragedy during Elizabethan and Jacobean period, and later we will be discussing some important tragedies written during this period, especially Shakespearean tragedy, and at the end we will discuss the decline of tragedy at the end of during the beginning of Romantic period, and at the end we will conclude the module. So let's start with the introduction. The purpose of this module is to introduce the students to the development of English tragedy between 1590 to 1798. In terms of history of English literature, the module takes as its beginning at the last years of Queen Elizabeth's reign, that is 1558 to 1603, and ends with the commencements of Romantic period with the publication of Lyrical Ballads in 1798. Other phases of English literature that falls within this 200 years and 80 years covered in this module are Jacobean period 1603 to 1625, Carolian period 1625 to 1649, Puritan period 1649 to 1660, Restoration period 1660 to 1700, and the 18th century, very as referred as to Augustan age, our age of prose and reason, and further neoclassical period. This module therefore would start with a discussion of the emergence of English tragedy and its growth and development in the Elizabethan and Jacobean period, and it would discuss different forms of tragedy drama that developed between 1590 and 1642. It will be followed by a discussion on the heroic tragedy of the Restoration period. Finally, there will be a discussion of the tragedies written in the 18th century and the decline of the tragic drama during the neoclassical period. Now let us first look at the origin and history of English drama. The emergence of dramatic forms in medieval England was a native phenomenon. The English drama emerged out of the rituals of English church. The earliest dramatic form, known as liturgic drama, was chanted a dialogue between cleric and masses. From 18th century onwards, such dramatic practices are recorded by the churches. Out of the liturgical drama grew the mystery and miracle plays. Mystery plays dealt with stories of creation, fall, and redemption. Like the liturgical dramas, these plays were written in Latin and performed during festivals like Easter and Christmas by the clergies. Miracle plays dramatized lives of the saints and stories, and miraculously intervention by Virgin Mary. Cycles of miracle plays exist from the 14th and 15th centuries. The miracles and mysteries were followed by the emergence of morality play in the latter half of the 15th century. A considerable development of the dramatic form took place in the middle of the 16th century with the emergence of the interludes, which it's more secular in themes and formed a link between the medieval religious dramas and the psychological plays of the Tudor period. One of the earliest drama is Ralph Royster Doyster, which was written in 1551. It is considered to be the first comedy was written by Nicholas Udall, a schoolmaster who was influenced by the Roman dramatists Plutus and Terence. And the first tragedy, Gorboduc, was written in 1562. It was written in imitation of the revenge plays of Seneca by Thomas Norton and Thomas Sackville. The early attempts matured into distinctive form of comic and tragic plays in the last two decades of the 16th century. in the hands of the university wits. The last years of 16th century also saw the construction of number of theatre houses on the south of the bank of River Thames and Rose. Thames and Rose was built in 1587, the Swan in 1595, the Globe, famous theatre, was built in 1599, and the Hope was built in 1613. These are some of the famous theatres of England, which at the time they performed various English dramas. After discussing initial dramas, initial plays like Morality, Miracle plays and interludes, let us discuss the later phases, those which came with the intervention of university wits, like of Marlowe and Keats. Young men like John Lilly, George Bailey, Thomas Kate, Christopher Marlowe, who studied at Oxford or Cambridge universities, moved to London and took up writing professionally. Among the university wits, it was Christopher Marlowe and Thomas Kate who has major contribution to the development of English tragedy. Christopher Marlowe's notable tragedies are Tamburlaine the Gate, which was published in 1590, and The Jew of Malta, which was performed in 1592 and published in 1623. Also, he has written Dr. Faustus, which was performed in 1590s and published on 1603. He has also another important drama, Edward II, which was published in 1592. After Christopher Marlowe, let us discuss Thomas Kyd and his contribution to the revenge tragedy and revenge conventions. Thomas Kyd was another very talented dramatist. Kyd is said to have written a number of plays, but his reputation as a dramatist today rests on the Spanish tragedy. It was presented in Rose Theatre in 1592. The play is significant and firmly establishing on revenge convention on English stage. So after discussing university wits and the dramatists like Christopher Marlowe and Thomas Kyd, let us discuss some features of revenge tragedy or standard revenge conventions. In revenge tragedy, generally a kin of the hero is murdered. The hero takes up the task of avenging the murder, often assigned by the ghost of the dead relative. There are many obstacles on the way of revenge, and there are much delay in the act of revenge. The revenge hero feigns madness. There is a play within the play scene. The hero also dies with the villains in the process of revenge. There is much bloodshed and horror. So these are some of the features of revenge tragedy. After discussing some of the features, important features of revenge tragedies, now let us look at some of important tragedies which are known as revenge tragedy. One of the important revenge tragedy is Shakespeare, Hamlet. You might know that Hamlet is an important character and still being recurrent and reproduced everywhere. Hamlet has the feature of delaying things, like he has this dilemma to do or not to do. Then there is another revenge tragedy, Webster, The Duchess of Malfi, and also The White Devil. These are also revenge tragedies where somebody has been murdered and revenge has been taken of that murder. Further, George Chapman, who was born in 1559 and died in 1634, Busy, the Amboise, and Revenge of Busy and Amboise, printed in 1613, are some of his revenge tragedies. Further, John Marston, who lived in between 1576 to 1634, Antonio's Revenge, which was printed in 1602, is an important revenge tragedy in the history of English literature. Also, Thomas Middleton, The Revenger's Tragedy, which was printed in 1603, and The Athis Tragedy, which was printed in 1611, are two important revenge tragedies of this period. So, while discussing drama or tragedy, without discussing William Shakespeare, it is almost incomplete. So, After discussing university weights, Marlowe, Kidd, and then other important revenge tragedy writers, now we'll discuss William Shakespeare and his tragedy and other plays. William Shakespeare was born in 1564 and died in 1616. Brought perfection to the English dramatic literature. He wrote 37 plays. That includes historical plays, it includes tragedy, comedies, tragicomedies. Tragicomedy is a thing that is developed in between tragedy and comedy. Written between 1590 and 1610, Titus Andronicus is supposed to be published in 1587. Romeo and Juliet, published in between 1593 and 94. Julius Caesar, published in 1599. Hamlet, 1599 to 1603. Othello, 1603. King Lear, 1605. Macbeth, 1606, Antonio and Cleopatra, 1606, and Carolinus, 1608, are considered to form the core group of tragedies. These are the tragedies which are still famous throughout the world, Shakespearean tragedy. Shakespeare was greatly influenced by the ideals of Renaissance humanism. Most of his tragedies depend on the strong individual heroes who bring about their own downfall. One of the important features of tragedy is the downfall or fall of the hero or the main protagonist. Unlike the classical tragedy, where the fate plays a crucial role in the downfall of the hero, these are tragedies wrought by the character or the protagonist of the play. In Shakespearean tragic conflict is often internal and is played within the mind of the hero. The plot of a Shakespearean tragedy is well constructed and hardly breaks the principle of necessity and probability. He, however, does not adhere to the principle of three unities as advocated by the classicists. The classicists proposed that in a tragedy or in any writing, there should be three components. But here, that are known as three unities, but Shakespeare doesn't follow that. Shakespeare also drops an occasional comic episode in the tragedies. The example, the potter scene in Macbeth, the grave digger scene in Hamlet, and the fool in King Lear. In his plays, contrary to the spirit of classical theory of tragedy. So what Shakespeare does, he brings different things even within tragedy and try to make it interesting. Like in potter scene, the potter and other friends, they drink and they make noises inside Duncan Palace, and that becomes quite interesting. It's an important scene in Macbeth. Macbeth brings his own downfall by ambitiously going after the crown, but suffers from the intense dilemma before choosing the path of evil. Macbeth wants to become the king of the kingdom, and thus he kills the king with the help of his wife and other friends. But at the end, his evil works get punished, and that brings his downfall. Hamlet is paralyzed by the quarrel that goes within his mind. He's always in dilemma, what to do and what not. He knows that his father is killed by his uncle and his mother, but he is not able to take decision. At the end, a play happens, and Hamlet tries to take revenge. King Lear is psychologically tormented once he realizes his foolishness in dividing his kingdom between Goneril and Regan, depriving Cordelia of her share. Othello is torn between belief and disbelief. Before being overrun by his jealousy and strangling his beloved wife to death, Othello is a suspecting husband. He suspects that his wife is in love with someone and he kills her. This brings the tragedy in his life and the play. Now, after discussing some of the important tragedies written by Shakespeare, we'll discuss the other kind of tragedy, that is domestic tragedy, which was developed in the Elizabethan and especially during the latter period, that is Jacobean period. Domestic tragedies are a group of plays which are written during late Elizabethan and Jacobean period with their focus on domestic life of English middle class men and women. While interestingly, if you notice, the earlier place were mostly on the kings and queens and various aristocratic families. But here, the plays are on common citizens or on their domestic lives. So that's why these are called domestic lives. This tragedy is specially focused on the troubled relationship between the husband and the wives. These walks with their domestic setting and probably were influenced by the religious morality plays, which we have discussed in the beginning. Thematically, most of these plays were centered on the debauchery of women leading to their tragic end. Now, let us look at some of the domestic tragedies written in this period. Two anonymous plays are from 1590s are The Tragedy of Mr. Arden and Feversham, and A Warning to Fair Woman. Another anonymous play of this genre was A Yorkshire Tragedy. Thomas Heywood, and his best work in the genre is A Woman Killed with Kindness, which was printed in 1607, is one of such domestic tragedies. Some of the tragedies, as you've seen previously, some of the tragedies are written by anonymous writers and not by some well-known writers. Next, Francis Beaumont, who lived in between 1584 to 1616, and John Fletcher, who lived in between 1579 to 1625, collaborative fruit, The Maid's Tragedy, which was published in 1610, is another prime example of this genre. From the title of this play, you can assume it says The Maid's Tragedy. Thomas Middleton's Woman Beware Woman, which was published in 1621, focuses on sexual passion and corruption of women represented in the play by Beatrice and Joanna. So these are some of the important domestic tragedies written in between that period. Now, after discussing domestic tragedy, now let us look at heroic tragedy. According to Dryden, a heroic play ought to be an imitation in little of an heroic poem, and consequently that love and valor ought to be on the subject of it. The heroic drama borrowed from the ancient and modern epics like Italian and French prose romances. Most of these plays were written in rhyming parameter, couplets, that is heroic meter, but also sometime in blank verse, also used. These plays predominantly deal with high ideals of love, honor, and courage. Love and honor is often shown in conflict, as the hero invariably finds himself fighting against side of his beloved. Faced with a dilemma, the hero either will have her renounce his love and see her slain, or letting his enemy go. To accompany the declamatory passages, highly artificial and spectacular operatic style of staging was custom in this place. Naturally, these plays presented characters of superhuman stature. So that's why these are called heroic tragedy. Now let's see some of the heroic plays and we'll discuss them. Sir William Davenant inaugurated the genre with The Siege of the Rhodes in 1556 and The Spaniards in Peru in 1558. Dryden was most prolific writer of the heroic tragedy. His most celebrated plays in this genre is All for Love and The Old Well Lost, which was published in 1678. Dryden, The Conquest of Granada, which came in two parts, in 1669 and 1670, written in rhyming couplet, depicts the double love between noble Almanzor and the beautiful Moor woman Almahide. Dryden, Aurangzeb, which was written in 1675, was based on the contemporary Indian history of how the hero wrested power from his rivals. Dryden wrote a number of other heroic plays, such as The Italian Indian Emperor, which was published in 1665, Tyrannic Love, which was published in 1669, and collaborated with Robert Howard in writing The Indian Queen, which was published in also in 1665. Also, if you see Thomas Otway's masterpiece, Venice Preserved, which was published in 1682, deals with the life, love, tragic death of Jaffier, a Venetian youth, and his wife Belvedere, the daughter of his enemy. Otway treats the conflict between twin brothers Castalio and Polydor for their love of the orphan girl Monimia in The Orphan, which was published in 1680. Further, Nathaniel Lee's Sophonisba, which was published in 1676, and The Rival's Queens, which was published in 1677, are best known plays in this category. Lee uses rhyme in the first one, but blank verse is used in the second play. Further, John Crow's best known work in the genre is of Caligula, which was published in 1698. Nicholas Roe wrote heroic plays like Tamerlane, which was published in 1702, and The Fair Peasant, which was published in 1703, and also Jane Seymour, which was published in 1714. So after discussing these heroic plays and other plays, now let us look why there was a decline in the writing of tragedy, especially in the 18th century. It has been argued that the neoclassical emphasis on the instructive role of literature was a prime reason behind the decline of the tragic drama, because the tragic form could not be conveniently used for moral instruction. Another argument proffered to explain the failure of tragedy is that neoclassicism, with its blind adherence to the classical rules, choked the creativity of the writers. So these are two important points regarding the decline of tragedy in the 18th century. Now let's see some of the tragedies within this period, written within this period. Shakespearean tragedies were still adapted in the 18th century for the English stage. John Crow's Jane Seymour, which was written in 1714, was based on the life of Elizabeth Jane Seymour, who was one of the mistress of King Edward IV. The play uses the form of heroic tragedy, embedding within it the elements from the domestic tragedy. Further, George Lillo's domestic tragedy, The London Merchant, or The History of the George Barnwell, which was published in 1731, was acted at the Theatre Royal in Drury Lane. The story of Barnwell's betrayal of his master, Throngwood, under the influence of seductive London prostitute Sarah Millwood, was very popular among the theatre goers in the latter part of this period. Also, Joseph Addison's Cato, which was published in 1713, is a regular neoclassical tragedy dealing with the life of Republican Cato, who commits suicide, unwilling to submit to the dictatorship of Caesar. Dr. Samuel Johnson, who lived in between 1709 to 1784, blank verse tragedy Irene, which was published in 1716, did not achieve much success when it was performed in 1749 by David Garrick under the title Mahomet and Irene. The influence of neoclassicism started ebbing towards the end of the 18th century, and the first romantic impetus started to be felt in the theater of Tristram and Darrell, translated as Storm and Stress. The leading acts of this movement, Goethe's play Gaus von Billingen, 1773, his novel The Sorrows of Young Dürer, 1773, and Schiller's play Die Räuber in 1781, went on to influence the British theatre, as these plays were translated and adapted for the English stage. Goethe was a German playwright and the famous world literature personality who has influenced the English stage in this period. Gregory Lewis' Gothic play The Castle Spectre, which was published in 1797, also S.T. Coleridge's tragedy Osorio, which was published in 1797, was revised and performed as Remorse in 1813. And Joanna Braille's first volume of plays on the Passion that included Count Basil, a tragedy on love and De Montfort, a tragedy on hatred, were influenced by the Sturm and Drang revolt against literary conventions of neoclassicism and emphasis on passion. Romantic revolt against neoclassicism, however, took a lyrical turn, and dramatic literature did not have a good life during Romantic period. So, the English tragic drama between 1590 to 1798 has its high and low. It had its golden time during the Elizabethan and Jacobean period, though there was a decline of the tragedy during the late Jacobean era. Tragedies continued to be written and staged until theatre houses were closed in 1642 during the England social and political problems. The Restoration tragedy altogether took a different form, becoming more like a heroic poem in its theme and style. The 18th century saw an overemphasis on instructive function of literature, classical rules, leading the further decline of tragedy. In the last decades of the 18th century, there is a resurgence of passion in dramatic literature. The plays written during this period, however, never achieved the greatness of the Elizabethan and Jacobean drama. So, in this module, we have discussed that various tragedies written in between 1590 to 1798. At the beginning, we have discussed tragedies, some of the features of tragedy, especially revenge tragedy. We have discussed some Jacobean tragedies, and further we have discussed some Shakespearean tragedy and how they are different from the earlier tragedies. Further, we have discussed the domestic tragedies, and at the end we have discussed the fall or decline of tragedies with the coming of Romantic age. So, hope you have understood the module. If you want to know further on this, please see the e-text or have a look at the further reading list and read on those. Thank you.